All right, what's going on? This is Matt from Tactical Obstruction, and if you're watching this video, you want to know about self-repairing bridges or bases. And in this video, I'm going to show you how to basically make everything involved in a self-replicating bridge and a base and how to build one. So right off here, first thing, like the most important thing, is you're going to need a cobblestone generator. Now, if you don't know how to do this, what you're going to need is you're going to need like a piston, a bucket of water, a bucket of lava, and some kind of redstone power source. But first of all, you're gonna want to make it like this. A lot of people make them differently. I don't know why. I like having the lava drop down instead, but I do. So you can copy my design on how I do this, or you can think up your own. It doesn't really matter. It's all the same stuff. This is just a really basic cobblestone generator. All you have to do is put water in the bottom, and then let me switch over to the lava now. Put it in the top, and there you go, cobblestone. All right. And now, why this is a generator is because the piston's there. The piston is going to push that cobblestone out of the way, retract, and another cobblestone will be made. Thus, it will, as long as it's getting a repeated power source and like it just constantly goes from like a redstone clock, then it'll work perfectly, and it'll just constantly push cobblestone out. That's the first step of making any self-repairing anything. You're probably already getting an idea how it works, but we're over here. I'm just gonna preview your previous attempt at making one, and I'm just not even gonna bother with it because it was pissing me off. So what you're gonna have to do is you're gonna need some redstone repeaters and redstone wire. And the reason you're gonna need repeaters is gonna become pretty clear here in a second, but watch. As you can see, it's broken. Why is it broken? Why is it not working? I don't think I'm given the thing long enough to form. Yeah, see, I'm not giving it enough time to form cobblestone. Right? Or did I not? Why did I punch a hole in there? That's dumb of me. Alright, yeah, I'm just not giving it enough time. So, this is why you're gonna need repeaters. Because you need to actually let the piston not push it for a long enough period of time to the point that cobblestone will form. There we go. Much better. Now this is going to be a little bit tricky of a thing because water and lava fall at a certain point. So what you're going to have to do is make sure you have enough time for both of them to fall down a level and then turn into cobblestone. So it's going to take some like tinkering around with redstone repeaters to find out the perfect timing. And it's going to take you a lot more tinkering around with the redstone repeaters you're going to see in a second to make sure that they hook up to the other pistons. But that's what we're going to do now. I'm a little hell-bent on getting this fixed, though. There we go. All right, and as of 1.8, pistons can only push 13 blocks. Well, at 13 blocks, they can't push anymore. It only has movement capabilities on 12 blocks. So as you see, I destroyed it and I repaired. Now, this technically can be your regenerating redstone bridge. It's really basic, but it's only going to be one block long. I guess you can technically have a whole bunch of generators keep pushing it, but that's not really cool enough. What I want is I want this generator to be next to my bridge, and then I want it to make a bridge going out into the bay here. So I gotta make myself a couple blocks. All right, and you're also gonna need obsidian. Sorry, I did not mention that in the beginning. Obsidian is required because pistons can't push obsidian, so you can set the limit before 13 if you wish. Like I'm gonna do, I'm only gonna have four pistons and make a bridge that's four long. So let's do this. All right, so I'm gonna connect my. It's really easy if you want. You can connect your other pistons to your main power source, which I have it set up on a clock over here. If you don't know how to make a clock, I did explain this in my how-to redstone video already. If you don't feel like going back and looking at that video, it's really easy. Just, I guess, Google it would be the easiest thing. Wiki it. But basically, all it does is just a circle with repeaters so that the power source gets delayed. And then it just spins in a circle and you can pull power off of it constantly. Right. As you can see, it's not working properly because the timers between, like, it made cobblestone, but there's a problem to the point, like, that, see how the piston's out? The other piston cannot push the new cobblestone into place to help the bridge generate. So what we're gonna have to do here is we're gonna have to make sure this is all proper and everything. So it's a real, like, tinkering thing. You're gonna have to really, like, play with it for a little while. Let's see, like, there you go. Right? And just like imagine when this bridge is complete. Well, after I need to explain how it's going to spread to those other ones, don't I? All right, see that long one. After it reached its like point where it continues to push. I have no idea why I'm messing with this one. I didn't really need to. But basically, the reason, see it on the very far one, how it's pushing that one over. When that reaches its max distance or the obsidian that will stop it, it will push into that other piston, where it will then stop and push into the second piston, and the second piston will start building itself all the way to the end. And so on, all the way to the end until it hits the obsidian. That's when your pistons will stop and your bridge won't make a noise and it will just sound all nice. So that was basically a bridge. And through the idea of this piston like regenerating with a cobblestone generator, some redstone, you can do a whole lot of stuff. I took it a step further and went over here and I made a regenerating fort. So let's say you're fighting like a creeper, as long as you have the bottom protected by something, he doesn't like screw with your redstone. Of which I don't think is ever gonna happen, but or okay, let's also say an Enderman's there and it just pulls a chunk out of your wall because Endermen like to troll like that. Oh, I put the redstone wire under the ground here. Wanna make sure that has to stay active. But yeah, just say an Enderman said, "Hey, I like that wall," and you rips a chunk out of your wall. Instead of being like, "Oh, that son of a bitch," you can just be like, "My base is gonna fix itself." See? Vroom, fixed. And this took a while. This is all running off one generator, so it takes a little while to circle around the whole base. But my entire base, except for the floor, will regenerate itself. As you can see, a problem here. Getting out kind of sucks, but I mean, just punch a hole, run out, your base fixed itself. So, I mean, with this idea, you can basically make anything build itself. You can have a base. Like, you can make it build a huge base while you're gone off adventuring. So, applications are endless, but I'm running out of time here, so this has been Matt from Tactical Instruction. Comment, rate, subscribe, I'll see you all later.